Yes, when you got up this morning, did you think you were going to see a cool kit review of the MPC Sodbuster? Well, I don't know if you did, but you are. This is what you're going to be watching in today's video. The 1/25th scale Chevy 4x4, the square body. We just call it a square body. I mean, everybody knows it. I love these trucks. They're my favorite style of Chevy pickup trucks. The Sodbuster is back with its sweet decal sheet, its lifted platform, its big honking desert dog tires. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you snag yours. It's got this really cool retro MPC style. I love when they have pictures of the actual model on the box, and it's that fuzzy Kodachrome style photos. These are the boxes I would see in Kmart all the time. There was a Kmart by our house, and that's where I got a huge amount of my model kits back then. This is their retro deluxe packaging. The reason I held this up was so that we make sure I don't forget. It says it has retooled grill, tires, tailgate, and more. We'll start off with those retooled tires. They are the Formula Desert Dog PCVs. They look crisper to me. They are a hollow plastivinyl material, so they should push over the wheels and tires. But we've got a nice tread pattern there, and the letters are quite prominent on both sides of the tire, so you can decorate those as you wish. We've got a set of clear. We've got a set of transparent red tail lights. We've got our stacked square headlights. This is the style of square body with that grill that my grandpa had in a black and yellow that he hauled his camper around with. We've got the cab glass. The rear glass and the front glass are one piece, which is extremely common for these styles of kits. We've got the grill of that square body right in front of you. We've got the sweet Sodbuster decal set, looking awesome right there. All the multicolors. We've got dash gauges in two colors, bow tie, those beautiful Scottsdale logos, side markers, plates, and we've even got tailgate emblems in white that say Chevrolet, along with all the front bumper turn signals. Everything is on there. Side markers in the back. So you've got quite a bit going on with that decal sheet. And on this side of the table, we have the chrome tree, aside from the grill that we already showed, with our optional lights. We've got air cleaner on there. We've got those nice spoked wheels. We've got our rear step bumper, our front bumper with those marker lights in them. We've got custom valve covers, square lights here. We've got steps for the side of the bed in chrome. We've got the nice mirrors, the nice Chevy mirrors on there. I like that style. That's my favorite. Plus, these are easier to glue on. You glue the base on, then you glue the mirror post into that once you get it all attached. We got carburation on there. Lots of nice stuff. So I'm going to switch sides of the desk, grab the white plastic, and I'll be back in a second. Getting back to the rest of review, check it out. We've got that newly tooled tailgate with chains to hold it closed or open. Got the Chevrolet logo where that decal will go. We've got our spare tire, so that might be newly tooled with the tailgate there. We've got our interior bucket here. These trucks had pretty plain interior doors. We've got nice detail in there. Carpeted floor, got the pedals molded in. This should be an automatic as far as I know. With our four-wheel drive shift lever down there. Grandpa used to let me pull that lever on the rare times he used four-wheel drives. Got our inner fenders with actual equipment molded onto them, wiring harnesses, mounts for the battery and stuff like that. We even got a little bit of wiring molded in right there. We flip it over, we've got our spare tire, which swings from that super noisy mount. If you ever took the spare tire out of one of these trucks and left that mount there and it goes, it swings back and forth, makes a terrible noise. We got the gas tank outside the frame rails. Remember that in the 80s, the big controversy? And our inner fenders, so it should be easy to paint this frame up and then mount it underneath the body. We've got our four-wheel drive drivetrain right here. We've got our front axle and our rear axle, suspension, springs, shocks, all molded together, so it should make sure that everything's facing the correct direction. Beautiful. General Motors dashboard, they got it right on there. That is the exact shape with the little bit of a grainy texture on the dash. We got our stock plastic GM steering wheel. We can do like a wood grain, a fake plastic covered wood grain. We could do a brushed aluminum on there. I had a GMC, it had the brushed aluminum. Gramps had that fake wood on there. We could do either one we want. We've got our radiator mount, our firewall. We got that big slab hood. And should you want to cut it out to build a bigger engine, there are two different cutout shapes in there. So do what you want with it. Build your model for you. We got the bucket seats, which are kind of rare for those style of, well, it is a step side, so probably did have bucket seats. A little more sporty option for you there. Then we've got on this tree here, we've got our transfer case. Full exhaust system all the way out the back. Sway bars. We've got different body trim parts here. We've got an optional push bar. That looks kind of neat. We might have to add that. We got a beautiful center console with cup holders in an MPC kit. Shock absorbers, drive shaft, one random wheel back. We got frame braces there. Grab some more trees. We've got our roll bar. I put that in the F-150 build. I might as well put it in this one. We got a fuel tank option. We got a spare tire carrier option for the tailgate. Remember, just because it's in the kit doesn't mean you have to use it. What else we got going on over here in plastic? We got a lot of plastic in this one. We got our small block here. I'm going to guess it's a 350. In a sportier truck, could be a 305, but I'm going to guess 350. Master cylinder and booster. We got a nice set of headers there. We got a set of radiator lines. We got stock manifolds. So you can do stock or mild custom. We got our stock valve covers, oil pan, cylinder heads, air cleaner. Water pump is separate from the timing cover. Interesting. And what do we have lastly in the box? Well, we've got another brush guard for the front end option. That's a really cool looking one. Protects the headlights and everything, so it's not just a push bar. We got the rest of our wheel backs, and we've got fender flares, which thankfully are an option on the truck. Again, another cool option to put on the truck if we're building it up a certain way. That is all the plastic. Now, you've already seen the thumbnail, but I'm going to start gluing my version together. I will see you all in just a moment. There's no real difficulties in the build to speak of. Everything goes together pretty darn easily. There are some nice small parts on this small block. I'm just going to call it a 350 for the entire time. I'm fine with that. We got our little fuel pump on there. We got our starter, our distributor. Whoop, it's leaning a little forward. We got to bring that back there. The glue's still drying on it a little bit there. We got our little two-barrel carburetor. We have oil filter, stock manifolds. My idea is to build this truck up as an appearance package that some dealer put together where they did the cool paint, they did the graphics and stuff like that, but they didn't do anything really under the hood or to the driveline, you know, aside from letting it sit a little higher on the springs and the fancier wheels and tires, just an exterior dress-up package that they charge a fortune for. So I want to do a stock engine, driveline, all that kind of stuff. So, and this makes a nice engine. You could put this in other things. It's got that transfer case on there. I mean, you could, that's a very nice representation. We've got our interior tub, needs nothing. I just leave the trees on so I can hold it when I paint. This little part here I discovered will clip to... These little holes will clip to the front bumper, and then this will glue up underneath the grill. So we're going to need to paint that body color and be careful with that. We got our bucket seats all set to go. We have our radiator support. I'll just paint that black in the front of the truck, whether it would have been body color in black. It doesn't matter to me. The shock absorbers, because the frame is a separate piece and everything, I can do the shocks, some nice dress-up colors. In that appearance package, we got our sway bar. I can paint that a metallic tone. We got a brush guard if we want to put it on. All that kind of cool stuff. The exhaust system and the drive shafts can get painted together. So I clipped all that stuff off the tree I didn't need. The wheel backs can get painted on their own tree to match the wheels. We got our spare tire. I don't think I'm going to use that spare tire carrier, but we'll paint it up just in case I decide to use it. The tailgate is a really nice fit into the box. In fact, once it has paint on it, it's probably not going to need any glue at all to fit right in there, which will help because that bed's got wood paneling in it. It's got wood slots in it with a metal round, and I want to be able to paint those. So it would be really hard to paint it if I glued the tailgate in like I usually do. So we'll leave that out. But when I pushed it in there, that new tailgate's a nice tight fit. So I don't think I'm going to need to use glue to get it in at the end. So we'll get that painted up in our body tone. The dashboard and the steering wheel will get painted the same color as the seats. Won't have an issue with those. These parts here, our stock air cleaner, our belt and pulley system, our brake booster, our CB radio, our reservoir tanks, and our radiator lines can all get painted up and then have their individual colors picked out later. Now we will get to the main assembly, which is the chassis, the body. We got the cool little light bar in the back, the little sport bar. We got that together. Once we just let it sit in the box and dry, and then we can paint it up on its own. The hood will get painted with the body and all the colors. We can take the body off the chassis. I glued the firewall in place. I'll just let that be body color when I do mine. And then we've got all of our inner fenders will get painted the same color as the frame. The box comes off nice and easy. The only work I did on that really was to glue the taillights in advance. I want those to match the body color. I can always, now that they're solidly glued in, I don't have to glue them in at the end of the build and panic about super glue. And I can always paint those black, a semi-gloss black at any point that I choose. If I choose, otherwise I can leave them body color too. It's going to be a custom painted pickup and then put the filler cap on there as well. I want that to complement the body. We got our drivetrain. And our frame, we got the little brace across there. Don't cut that nib off, it hangs on there. We've got our differentials hanging there from the springs, and we are all set to go. That's super easy to put together. The sway bar is going to mount in those holes there. The shocks will mount on the holes there to there, and then the shocks will mount on these little pins. Don't cut them off, to the axles. There's holes, or there's pins on the axles as well. So we'll get that all mounted up and stuff after we get painted in individual colors. And I am going to hit the paint booth right now.
Puertorriqueña.
let's grab a look at what we've got done, what I need to do to finish up this sweet sod buster. So far, being an older MPC kit, lower parts count, haven't had any fit issues or fights or problems or anything. The wheels do fit a little loose in the tires. I shouldn't say the wheels, the wheel backs fit a little loose in the tire. The wheel actual rims fit nice and tight in there. So what I did was I attached the wheel backs to the axles that we'll see in a moment, and I put the main wheel part through the tire, and then for final assembly I can just place those tire wheel assemblies onto the wheel backs that are already joined to the chassis, and those should hold just fine. If need be, a dab of rubber cement will hold the inside of the tire to that wheel back. I've got the cab ready to go. I glued the grill in place so that I could discuss what we're going to be doing, and the hood pushes in place. There's a little tiny hole in the bottom of the hood brace that you can make sure that the hood holds in tight, so you know that it's in the correct location when you glue your grill in. Then we will take the front grill, and you saw that I painted that panel body color and then glued it in the video. And when we're all done, that will simply fit between the fenders and rest on there, and that's going to look pretty darn nice. So shouldn't have any problems there. It's a nice fit between the fenders, and I can glue it from behind, or I can put a little bit of super glue right there and right there and then slide it into place. So that's going to be a nice color matching feature, and it should make a nice gap in between the bumper and the grill. I did paint the grill emblem instead of using any decals provided. I just chose to do it because I was already working on it. Blacked out the vents. We got our glass in. Got the rear thing, got all our trim done. It looks very nice and just needs the decals applied to the cab. The rear bumper, whoever designed the molds way back in the day, instead of joining it at the bottom of the bumper to the tree, they joined it at the top. And I decided anyways, I wanted it to have a rubber or a plastic step on it. So instead of repainting this with chrome paint, I just masked it and gave it a black step on the top, and that will look pretty cool. We got our CB antenna that I did black out. I'm not sure if I'm going to use it or not, but if I do, I wanted to make sure I detailed it. The beautiful mirrors have to go on when we're all done. I will attach those in two pieces and then do our decals and all that. The interior is all set. I did the interior with a darker wood grain. Then I did the bed, attached the CB radio, got our center console, our seats, minimal detailing on the door panel. The dash decals went in. I've shown that on a bazillion videos, so I skipped it on this one. And we've got the interior set. Looks just like a General Motors interior for a square body. And then the box, you can see, fits beautifully on the chassis. We'll pop that off. Got the light bar in the bed. I tinted the lights yellow with just a yellow Sharpie. I thought that would match good with the golden body. Got the bed all done with the chrome bed strips in there. I use my chrome pen for that. You've seen me use that in other videos, just a Molotow chrome pen. Got our tailgate in place. Got our tail lights in place. Did a little bit of chrome on the gas cap. We got to put decals on here and run the decals on the bed and everything. And then we'll get to the chassis right now. You know, you might see some of the wheel and tire package fall off because I don't have them pressed in super tight. But it did go together just fine. As you can see, I'm just going to press those in. You saw how I detailed those white letters. Why didn't I use that other technique where I had the piece of plastic and I dipped the tire into it? Because these tires are so far in on the inner curve that when I try to dip the tire in paint, all I do is get the tread covered in paint, which wouldn't look very cool. So the letters are nice and prominent on that new mold. They stick out quite a ways from the sidewall. So it was easy to just use a white acrylic marker to do that. Do not use enamel. If you use an enamel marker, never going to dry on vinyl. It just does not dry on vinyl. Underneath the chassis, great detail. Got our fuel tank, got our cross members, got our 350, our four-wheel drive drivetrain, and our dual exhaust system. Nicely looking. The wheel and tire package looks pretty tight, especially if you do a darker metal on the wheel backs, because then you can actually see each individual spoke, so you can see the wheels will just fall off if we mess around with it too much. But they press in and hold for the most part. not going to be a problem. And from the top, the underhood detail with our radiator shroud and our 350 and our distributor, transmission, transfer case, all lines up lovely and looks great. All I have to do at this point is my final press fit assemblies, get that bumper glued on, get the rear bumper glued on, and attach the cool decals to complement that gold body color. I'm going to do all that, and we'll be back on the turntable. My version of MPC via Round 2 Sodbuster, the Chevy 4x4 pickup truck with the cool step side, the light bar, the CB antenna, the CB underneath, these really sweet mirrors that I would love to see as individuals for other kits, is all done. I built it up my way. I gave it a sweet metallic gold color, not too strong of a color, but just a nice palette. And then I used the side decals. I did not use the hood decals, and I did not use the Sodbuster emblems. As you see on the box art, it looks really cool with the hood emblems, the Sodbuster logos, and the side decals. I chose to use just the side decals on my pickup truck. I like that big flat square body hood. I wood grained the bed with a lighter grain of color of paint, and then I did the dashboard in the fall wood grain in the much darker tone that I remember seeing on those. All of that stuff is quite easy to work on. They've got the newly tooled tires, which look nice. You saw how I decorated those tires on this round, where I did them a different way. The wheel and tire package fits on nicely. I said I just pressed on those tires at the end, and you can see it all sits straight and level. The box goes onto the frame. The interior is a tight fit into the cab. I recommend when you're holding the cab in your hand with the hood up here that you snap the interior in towards the hood and then sort of slide it backwards into the cab. Seems to work a lot better than trying to shove it up inside the cab. You still will have to spread the bottom of the doors to get the interior in no matter how you do it, but once it's in, it looks great. I did it in that old man tan. You could do it in any of the colors that were available. You could also source a bench seat, I think would look pretty cool in a Silverado like this. We got those nice Scottsdale logos on the fenders. The decals laid down, even though they were over some edges and stuff like that, I didn't have any problems. The marker lights went on fine. The mirrors, I attached the base first to the door with super glue, and then I just hung the mirror on there and dripped a little super glue in the attachment point, positioned them, and they went on nice. I like that. The bumpers went on easily. The nose glues in. The grill glues in just at the edge of the fenders and everything. So I didn't have any problems with this kit. It's not a high parts count, but it does look very nice. It's a nice looking Chevy pickup when you are all done. This should be out at most of the hobby shops already, so I will link down in the description where you can snag yours. I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending this over. I built my version of it and really enjoyed it. You don't have to wood grain the bed or anything. You can make it look like a painted bed, even though it's got the wood in there with the grains and all that. But for a step side with all the other decorations, I think this is something you'd see on a dealer's lot. They would go nuts for it. I do recommend white lettering the tires. I just think, just like the box art, it really makes these older style square bodies pop, and it was extremely common to have white letter tires back in the day, and they make it quite easy to do so. They said they remolded the tires. They look crisp, they look sharp, they sand well to give them a tread look to them, and I just enjoy these old pickup trucks. We did the step side Ford from AMT, now we did the step side Chevy from MPC, and had a good time on both. I want to thank you all for watching, for your nice comments, for sticking with the channel all these years, and I will see all of you at the next review.